Okay, Nelly, you ready? This is your birthday song. This isn't very long. Happy birthday, Buzz. I love you.
Incredible with Nat and Natalie.
You got, it looks like he's, why are you holding it? Try again.
Alexa, stop. Alexa, play Unforgettable from Nat King Cole and Natalie Cole. No, no, no. Alexa, no, no. Alexa, please play Unforgettable.
And who's this?
And that's the big guy Buzz.
The old man. The old man of the mountain.
He's the one who keep us all in line.
It's impossible.
Oh, it might be a bit impossible.
And,
and
the cameraman. What do you
want?
Here we go. No,
don't take me doing this, dummy.
Buzz and Carol.
What is he saying, Taken?
Hi, Deb. I have a couple to share with you. One is back when we were kids and Mom was out of town and you would make us lunch. My favorite lunch consisted of peanut butter and Miracle Whip sandwich. Pretty creative, and no one thought I'd eat it. Another one was...
Hi, Grampy. Happy 90th birthday.
Well, following Peter's thing, I didn't get peanut butter and mayonnaise. I got peanut butter and ketchup. And it was an adapted taste. Gardner liked his Heinz. So that's what we got.
Oh,
yeah.
Hi,
Grampy.
Happy 90th birthday.
Am I on? Just to... further talk about the sandwich creations that Dad used to make for us as children. Being the third and the baby of the family, I guess I got preferential treatment because I didn't get mayonnaise and I didn't get ketchup, but the sandwich that Dad and I created was peanut butter and bologna on white bread, and quite honestly, delicious. You should try it sometime.
Another one was on the river trip you came out to Utah for your 30th wedding anniversary, and we experienced the drive-thru at Wendy's. If you'll recall, that was Homer and Marge Simpson going to the drive-thru. And the third came...
So one of my most favorite memories of Buzz is we were at Sunapee, and we were all sitting around just talking on the porch, and Buzz got up to, presumably, and he comes back and he sits down, and we said, you know, Buzz, where'd you go? And he said, I just went to the bathroom. And we said to him, well, by any chance, did you stop in the kitchen? And he said, no, I didn't stop in the kitchen. Why? And the reason we had asked him was he had chocolate sauce dripped down his chin, and it was all the way down his shirt from dipping his finger in the chocolate sauce in the kitchen. And he's trying to tell us that, oh, no, I didn't go in the kitchen. And it was one of my favorite memories of Buzz.
Another wonderful memory of Dad was when I was a sophomore and just made the high school football team. Our first game, Chris Mulligan, who was the starting tailback and senior, was having issues due to the heat. And I had made the team, but wasn't really expecting to do a lot of playing time other than special teams. Well, in the second half, after halftime, when the player was having so many issues, the coach said, Dave, you're playing the second half. And I recall early on in the second half, I got a toss around the left side, maybe a 50 or 60 yard run down the sideline. And I remember in the corner of my eye, my dad running down the sideline with a camera.
Happy birthday, Grampy. I wish we could see you.
And the third came off that trip when those two kids wouldn't stop calling you Buzz. Hey, Buzz. They wouldn't leave you alone.
I just wanted to say happy 90th birthday, Buzz. We're really sad that we can't all be together this year, but rest assured we are making plans, and as soon as it's safe to travel, we plan to all get together and have a wonderful celebration of your 90th birthday. I love you so much, and happy 90th. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Anyway, happy 90th. We'll give you a call tomorrow. Sorry we couldn't be there to share it with you. And hopefully we can see you this fall.
Okay, we'll come back.
Happy birthday, Grampy. We miss you. We love you. He's a man of very few words.
Happy birthday.
Another favorite memory kind of involved me, but more David. Back when David was in high school and showed up late one night. Rolled into the driveway at 2 a.m. with the lights off. David telling me, now, Michael, be quiet because Dad, Mom, I'm really late. And as I walk by this big window, there's Dad standing there in his pajamas with his arms folded and his hair was like straight out with this dirty look. As I walked in the house, I said, hi, Dad, I'm home. I'm on time. Too bad David is going to get in trouble. Laughing my way upstairs. That was quite a funny memory. And I guess one of the...
Hi, Grampy. Is it Grampy?
Hi, Dad.
We wish you
a happy 90th birthday from Utah.
Okay, Grampy, take two.
So happy 90th birthday, Dad. I hope you have a great day. And I'm in my bathroom. I just came out of the pool, so that's why I look like I do. But have a great day. I wish we were all together celebrating it with you. But we're not. We're there in spirit. Have a great day, and we'll chat soon. Happy 90th.
Cannonballs, flips.
Yeah.
Swan dive.
Somersaults.
Yeah.
No.
That's what you are.
Unforgettable, though near or far.
Like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more
unforgettable in every way.
And forevermore,
and forevermore,
that's how you'll stay.
That's how.
That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.
Thank you. has someone been born?
That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.